whenever you present drawback calculations to customs and border protection, you have to have some sort of methodology which is worked out. And very important here is the methodology which you adopt. You cannot jump back and forth, you must stick to it. But more importantly, you really must be aware of the types of methodologies that exist. So we have three methodologies, and those methodologies can be done under the two ways: abstract method and a schedule method, right? Abstract method, right, just includes summary that were actually used, right? The schedule method, as the name implies, it's a prediction. You say this is the scheduled exportations based on our inventory procedure, and based on the schedule, we think this much of drawback is appropriate. So it goes into this. Some of familiar with taxes, especially with the corporate taxes, it's kind of reminiscent of the accounting method where in the Internal Revenue Service is requiring you to adopt either the cash-based method or the accrual method of accounting. So it has its own rules. Let's take a look at the methodologies and see how this stuff is being tested on the exam. So the used-in method talks about the methodology which is based on the actual whatever, as the name says, whatever was actually used in it, right? Of course, to use that method, you cannot have any valuable waste. No valuable waste, and this example suggests, right? If you have 10 widgets that were used in production of an export product, right? And one widget was wasted in the production process. For example, you are making a chemical, right? And you have to use number of chemicals, and whenever you mix them up, the chemical reaction takes place. And as a result of the reaction, that particular chemical used disappears. It's no longer around. So that's one of the examples of so-called waste, right? But you still can claim drawback. So in reality, you are exporting really 9 widgets, right? Because one has disappeared. But you can still claim 10 widgets drawback because you actually used 10 widgets. So whatever you're using in, you're claiming as a part of the drawback. The next methodology is appearing in method. So unlike used in method, if one widget disappeared, let's say that during that chemical reaction that widget disappeared, you cannot claim of whatever was used, but you can claim of whatever is inside the product. So using a chemical reaction, if that because of that chemical reaction, that particular chemical is gone, it can no longer be part of this mixture, which is being exported or destroyed, then you cannot claim that particular chemical since it disappeared as a part of the drawback. Of course, the limitation, it cannot be used if there are multiple products resulting from the manufacturing process. All right, so used in a less valuable waste method. This is kind of like kind of like use in, except it accounts for waste. So remember the first used in portion, you could not use waste as a part of it. Here you can deduct waste. So let's say you were using one, you were using 10 widgets and one widget was wasted, and that one widget cost was the value of it was 0.5. So you deduct 0.5. So the amount of drawback you can get is 9.5. And again, this is just rough abbreviation of what's going on. And of course, those three used in, used in appearing in, and used in less valuable waste can be used as a part of abstract method or the schedule method. All of the following methods are methods of claiming manufacturing drawback, except, and then we see the laundry list of methodologies again. Again, we are here talking about only on manufacturing drawback, right? So the following methods are methods for claiming manufacturing drawback, except, and then used in, abstract or schedule, appearing in, used in less valuable waste, other usual four suspects. So they're good. This one is good. This one is good. This one is good. Derived from is not on the list. And since we're looking for exception, we pick number A. So again, very important. This relates to the manufacturing drawback.